Hey guys, welcome back to the video. I hope you all are doing great. Now I know it's a little bit delay to upload this video, so first of all I'll apologize for that. And let's move ahead with today's video. So what is today's video? As the title says, we are going to make our own prediction bot, stock market prediction bot, or stock market prediction AI also you can call it as. Now before moving into this prediction thingy, doing programming and stuff, let me tell you this. Now it's not a 100% accurate prediction, I'll tell you that. It's not a 100% accurate prediction, but it's definitely going to do a prediction which might help you, and you can even put in your portfolio if you have any projects to be done, assignments, or you know, job interviews, so you can put that in the list. So in the beginning itself, I've told you it's not going to be a 100% accurate prediction, but it's definitely going to give you a prediction and help your work to be done easier. Now if you want to do the analyzation, you need to do a little bit of personal analyzation and then invest in any of the companies or in the stock market also. Now coming into where do I invest, what are the companies I invest in, or through which app or which software do I use? So here is the app which I use, that is Grow. Now Grow is a very simple and easiest app to be used to invest in any of the companies. I personally use it and I would highly recommend you to use Grow app. Here you can invest in the IPOs of the company, any company which you would prefer to, US stocks and many more also. And if you go through the link in the description which I have given you, you will get a plus 100 rupees in your wallet, and you can use that for investment. And you use that link and refer it to your friends, you get again plus 100 rupees in your wallet. And what do you do with this money? You can either withdraw it or you can either use it to invest in any of the companies. And if you're wondering which stock did I invest in, the first stock which I invested in, so I invested in a US stock, that is Starbucks. So you can also use this bonus rupees in your wallet and invest in any of the US stocks or any stock which you would prefer. Now coming back to the stock market prediction bot. Now again, I told you at the beginning, it's not going to be 100% accurate, but it's going to help you. If you want, you can do the analyzation, personal analyzation, which I would recommend as Screener. Now this is a website where you can do your personal analyzation, where you can check out the promoter holding and all that stuff, and also do the prediction which we are going to do today, the stock market prediction bot. With the help of these two, you will get an accurate analyzation, and then you can invest in any of the companies which you would like to invest in. Now the people who know what stock market is and what are these things, great, but the people who don't know, in short I'll explain. So stock market investment, or also called as equity shareholding, is a kind of fund given to a company, or a money provided from you to a company to perform well. Or you would just analyze and feel that this the company will perform well. And let's suppose the company performs really well, you will get return. But let's suppose if the company does not perform that well, you might have a little risk. So that's basically what share market is and what equity shares is. And about equity shares, you even get voting rights. So let's suppose you invested in one of the stocks. Let's suppose Tata Motors. So if you invested in Tata Motors, and Tata Motors does really well, and also they give you the voting right for certain decision. So that's the plus point of equity shares. Now I hope you got to know what this equity share market is. There are many more things in share market and stuff. If you want to learn how these things work, how I do my analyzation, what are the things I use, what are the stocks which I bought, all these things, you need to comment down below if you want it. Just comment down, yes, I want the analyzation video or anything. You just comment it, and if the comments are filled with all these things, I will definitely make a detailed video, or if you want even a series also, if you would really like it, I'll make a series on that. So it will help you, and it will help you in investing in the companies. So coming back to this prediction board, now we are going to use a package, also a website called as Yahoo Finance. Now Yahoo Finance is going to give us all the information of the stocks. So through this, we are going to do the prediction. Now again, in the beginning, as I told you, it's not going to be the 100% accurate, but through Yahoo Finance, it might be a little bit accurate, but as I told you, you need to do your personal analysis. So in the beginning, I've told you, you can use the screener.in. If you want, I'll leave the link of that. You can just check out. There you can do your personal analysis. So you'll have both the analysis done and then you can invest. So that's what is basically the stock market prediction is. So without wasting more time, let's get straight into the video, guys. So guys, right now I am in the PyCharm right here. As you can see, I'm in the folder of PyCharm. Now, if you're asking me why I've chosen PyCharm and not Visual Studio, if you want, you can choose Visual Studio. I'm not telling don't choose Visual Studio, but right now I've chosen PyCharm. The first reason is this project, what I tried in PyCharm, so I think it works in only in PyCharm. It's not that it's not going to work in Visual Studio, and I did not try. If you want, you can just try it out, check it out. But if you have to take my recommendation, I would tell check out PyCharm. It'll be even more easier. And second reason why I've chosen PyCharm is we are going to connect our advanced virtual assistant. Now in one of my video, I've already told you, after our deep learning machine learning course, we are definitely going to do a video on a series on advanced virtual assistant. We are going to create our advanced virtual assistant. So we are going to connect our virtual assistant to the stock market prediction or the prediction thing. And that's the main reason why I have chosen PyCharm. Now it's up to you if you want to choose PyCharm or Visual Studio, totally up to you. And now coming to the packages that are required. Before that, the packages which are required, I'll just tell you this. If you want to know how to install PyCharm, I've done a video that is how to install AutoPy and MediaPipe. There itself I've told you how to install PyCharm. So if you want to check that out, the link is there. Click on the link and you can, if you want, even install AutoPy and MediaPipe, you can install that also. So all the link will be there in the description. And the second thing is, this video might be a bit long. I have told you, it might be a little bit long, so stick with me. I'm definitely going to show you everything. And apart from this, if you want the code, the source code, I will leave that in the description. The whole source code, the full source code, you'll get it. You can check out, copy it, paste it, make your job easier also. But if you want to learn, you can do it here. Now coming into the packages that are required, the first thing you will require is Pandas. Now, if you want to install Pandas, it's very simple. It's just pip install Pandas, or you just put pip install Pandas. Okay. Okay. I just made a mistake right here. Pandas. Okay. So this is the thing. So you need to install Pandas. Now, why Pandas? Because Pandas is a package where we are going to store data. And we can either manipulate it, we can analyze it, all those things with the help of, Pandas. And apart from Pandas, we also need Datetime. Now, I think Datetime is already there, you need not install it. But again, if it's not there, you can just, do the pip install thing. And now talking about what are the other things you require. So you need a package called as matplotlib. Okay, so this is the package. So you there can go to the Python website, and you can just put, you can get it from there, copy it, paste it here, pip install, it's there. So you, if you want, I'll leave those link also, you can just get it. And apart from this, we need a package called as sklearn. Now this package is very powerful, and we need this package in our deep learning, machine learning, and also might also require for the neural network also. So we need this, so you can install this for even deep learning also. So just you need to install this sklearn. And apart from this, what we need is it is KARAS. Okay, so you can even install this. So again, I'll tell you, I will leave all the link of this from the Python. You can just go to that, copy it, and just paste it and click enter. Now I'm not going to click enter because I've already installed it. And secondly, you need to create a file here in PyCharm. So I'm sure you must be knowing that how to create all that stuff. So now let's do one thing. Let's import all these packages. So first let me import math. So we are going to import math. So once we have imported math, next let's import numpy. So we might need numpy also. Now numpy, if you've not installed, you can either put pip install numpy or else it'll all be there. It's inbuilt. If you have installed OpenCV, you will get it with that. So if you want to do that, you can just do OpenCV also, if you are thorough with whatever I'm doing. So now let's come back to this and we put numpy as np, yeah. And then we are going to import pandas as pd, yeah. So you're going to import this and I will send you the source code which I'm going to send you, you will get. I'll mention everything what this package is for, why we require this package. So if at all you are thinking why are we just using this, you'll get to know there. So I'll definitely add that for you guys, so you'll just have an idea of what we are doing, okay. So we have done pandas, and from after this we are going to put from date time, okay. From date time we are going to import date and time delta. We're gonna put time delta. My keypad is not working, I believe. Just let me just check. Yeah, I think it's working right now. Import a date and time DLAT. Yeah, perfect. Now after this, next we are going to import is from pandas. So from pandas dot plotting import register, yeah, this one, okay. And if we have done with this, next what we are going to do is, this is basically for the calendar data, okay. Now why we have imported date and time, the thing is this is going to tell you the date obviously, and if you want the year also, these two are basically for that, okay. So you get it. And now next what we are going to do is we are going to import math plot live dot, we're gonna put it as plot, yeah, and as we're gonna put it as plt. Fine. Once you have done this, just make a little bit correction right here. I think should be fine, should be good, yeah. And now next import the other things. So next again from import math plot live dot dates as m dates, yeah. Can keep it anything, I just get it as m dates. Fine. Now from sklearn dot processing import, so we are going to import min max scalar. Fine. Now that's done. Now once this is done, let's go to the next. After we have done this, I think we are missing with one package, I believe, yeah. From sklearn what we're going to do is dot METRIC, yeah, import mean absolute error. Fine. And even, okay, wait, I did a mistake, I believe it should be fine, and I'll put a comma. and then mean square. Yep. So these are the things what we require, and there's still more from. Forgot about that. From SK. Oh, sorry, not sklearn. KRAS. Now, which is this package? This package is again for deep learning, machine learning, and basically not for machine learning, for neural network and deep learning, both connected, interconnected. This is required. Okay. Now, once we have done this, what we're going to put it as models. We'll click enter, import, capital S, E. Did I import it 2 times? Yeah, I believe. Yeah. Sequence. Yeah. And after from, again we're going to put from KARS dot layer. This time we're going to put as layer import LSTM fine and dense. I think D should be capital right here. If I'm not wrong. Wait. Let me check some problem there right here. Layers, I believe. Yes. From layers. I think yeah. Now it's fine. So once we have done this, now let me tell you what are the things that we are going to do. Now after this we are going to import Yahoo Finance. So if you have not installed Yahoo Finance, it's just simple pip install via Yahoo Finance, or you can just at times it comes inbuilt. If it's not this, you can just put it as pip install Yahoo Finance. Now as I told you, with the help of Yahoo Finance we are going to do this. Now what we are going to do is we are going to do a prediction index. After that we are going to do create a test data. And then we are going to do RNN data, okay. And from these, we are going to generate a training data and a test data, fine. And after this, what we are going to do is basically we are going to find the mean absolute error, which we just now put, and then the absolute percentage error and median absolute percentage. So all these things we are going to put. And after that we are going to design the chart, okay, not chart, we are going to define the chart, sorry, correction right there. And after this we are going to put the closing price, we need the closing price and the last price and getting the data from Yahoo Finance. So it's a huge thing. Now I told you in the beginning, it's going to be a long video. So stick on with me and I will tell you what are the things. So first now we'll do something called as today. So we'll just define today is equal to date dot today, and yeah, in the tuple. Yep, tuple is already there. Now next what we're going to do is date underscore today is equal to let's put it as today dot str fine, yeah, and we'll put the percentage. Now this thing we have done it in our virtual assistant also. If people are from the beginning, if you're following from the beginning, you will be knowing this, but if you have not, it's there, the video is there in the channel, you can just check it out. Now again the percentage. Now this is the year month date, okay, year month and the date, simple. Now we'll put the date and that's done, and now we're gonna click enter, and now we are going to give it a start date. So I'll keep it from 2019. Oh, I want it from 2019. So let's put it as is equal to. We'll put in a string 2019 slash. Sorry, hyphen from Jan. I believe Jan should be fine. I believe. Jan, and again from first. I want it from the beginning, okay? From Jan. Now I'll click enter. Fine. Now once this is done, we are going to ask the user which stock he wants. So this is the main thing guys, okay? Because if you're going to connect our virtual assistant, we are going to do this thing. Fine. So we'll put get stock, and we'll put as stock is equal to input, and after input you want to put enter stock name. Fine. So we are basically taking the stock name. So stock name. Fine. And after we have done this, what we are going to do next is we will put stock name. Yeah. Oh, let's do one thing. I'll come top right here and I'll just put this as capital S because we are going to repeat this again. So stock, yeah, here we'll put it as stock name is equal to stock. Fine. Okay, once you've done this, click enter, and we can either put the symbol also right here, so we can just give a symbol for the stock, like for the chart, let basically. I'll keep the symbol like maybe like this something. Yeah, so let's keep this like this. This is just a simple, just this chart symbol or whatever you can call it as. And now what we are going to do is we are going to import certain data. Fine. Now what we are going to do is import pandas underscore data reader. Fine. As web reader. Yep, that should be good. So we have given it as import pandas data reader as web data reader. Fine. And what we are going to do is we are going to define the, we are not define it, we are, I can even define also, but let me put it as df is equal to web reader dot data reader. Fine. And we can put the symbol right here, symbol, and the start start is equal to date underscore start. Yeah, it should be fine. And after this we are going to put even the end, so end is equal to date is equal to end underscore today. Yeah, so even this, after this we're gonna put a comma and then data underscore source is equal to Yahoo. Okay, and let's click enter. Now once we have done this, we are going to import which is Yahoo Finance. Fine. So let's import Yahoo Finance or Y Finance also. So Y Finance as, wait just a second, as YF. Fine.
Now, if you want to install this Yahoo Finance, you can just put pip install y finance and you'll get installed. Okay. Now we are going to put df is equal to yf dot download symbol. So we'll tell symbol. Now we have already defined a symbol, but still we'll put it as download symbol, and we're going to put it as start data. Start is equal to date underscore start, and apart from that we're going to put end is equal to date underscore today. Fine. Now once this is done, what we are going to do is we are going to come out of the tuple and click enter, and now we are going to print this. Fine. So let's print it right now. So we'll click enter and we will put print df dot shape. Okay, print df dot shape. Once that we have done, we are going to put df dot head, and we're going to get it as a numerical value of 4, or let me keep it as 5. Yeah, 5 will be fine. Okay, and now we have to click enter. Now if you've done this, next thing what we're going to do is we're going to use the register underscore matlab lot live converters, and with the help of that we're going to assign the colors, stock name, all this stuff. Okay, and we're going to basically put in the chart, the requirements which you want it in the chart. Now what we're going to do is first we're going to put it as register. Once we've done that, I'll come down and click enter, and we're going to put the years is equal to mdates dot year locator, and we'll put the tuple and enter. Fine. Then we're going to put the figure comma axis 1 and is equal to mlt dot sub plots, and we're going to put the figure we don't want the tuple right now, we want the figure size right here, or figures I believe, yeah, figure size is equal to, and now the tuple, and then we're going to put 16,6. Fine. 16,6. Now let's come out of the tuple. Fine. Once we are out of this, what we're going to do next is we are going to put axis 1 dot x axis dot set underscore major. Did I put the axis right there? Yep, I put the axis right there. Let me just check properly. Set major underscore locator. Yep. And once we've done this, we'll come out of this. Fine. So major locator has been assigned to that, and I think we need to put even the year to the tuple, I believe. So let me do one thing. Let's put the years. Okay, years. Sorry. So we'll put the years right here. Now let's put the x coordinate. We'll define the x coordinate. X is equal to df dot axis. index dot index, yeah, df dot index, and for y we are going to give y is equal to df big brackets and the close, we'll assign it to close, so we'll put it and close. Yeah, Now once we have done this, we have come down and put it as axis 1 is going to be fill. Now we are going to give the color and all. So fill between, so we'll put fill between underscore, sorry, the tuple x comma 0 comma y comma color, we'll give the color first. So color is equal to hashtag, we'll put the hashtag B9E15A, yeah, blue. I think we should use the blue color, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, I think we should be fine. Okay, now once we have given this color name, we'll put it as AX1 dot legend. Wait just a second. Yeah. Okay, why am I pad? No pad giving me all these things today. Yeah. Okay, so we'll put the big brackets now and put the stock right here. Stock name. So we'll put the stock name right here. And once we have done that, we'll put the comma and the font size. We will require the font size is equal to. Let's assign it 12, what I will require, and click enter. Fine, and now what we're going to do is we're going to give color again. So let's put it as plt dot title, and once we have put the title, we will put the stock name right here. The stock name plus we'll give, we want from the date, from let's put it as plus date. Yeah, plus date. I think there's something which we have to add right here. Yep, this one right here. Adjust this properly and then we can move on with this. Okay, we don't require a string right here. Yep, that should be fine. Yeah, from, after we put the date, or date is equal to start. Yeah, and after this we're going to put the plus again, and we're going to put it as 2 in the string, and we're going to put it as plus and date, date today, we put it as date today. Fine. Once you have done that, we are going to put the font size. So we'll put it as font size is equal to 16. Okay, so font size is equal to 16, we have put that. Now once we have done this, we'll click enter and we will put, or we'll give color. First of all, let's give the color of blue to this, I believe blue and green, anything will be fine. So let's put the color right now. So we're going to put plt again dot, this time we are going to put the plot. We'll put y first and then the color. Wait, I don't think so you will be able to see this. Yeah, I think now this will be fine, right? So color is equal to, we are going to assign it to, let's assign it to hashtag. Again, we are going to bring the hashtag 039DFC. Okay, and once we have done this, we are going to put the label as, is equal to the stock name. Fine, we'll put that as stock name, and then we will put line width should be I put as 5, line width, let it be 5, line width is equal to, 5 is too much I believe, let me put it as 1.0, that's fine. If it is in decimal also it should be fine, won't make any difference, so let's put it right here. And let me just make a small adjustment right here, fine? Okay, and now we are going to put it as, again, plt dot y label, okay, and then we are gonna put it as maybe stock, we could put as stocks, yeah, stocks will be good, stocks, and then we put the font size also, font size, no, sorry, if I'm not wrong, yep, this should be fine, font size is equal to 12, fine, and we'll click enter. So font size has been given, we have given the stock name, and once you have given the stock name, we have given the line width also. So yeah, line width, I think I've made a mistake right here, yeah, line width, and we have given the font size again right there, date today is also given, and yeah, so basically we have given everything right here, the color requirements, everything we have already given. Now what we are going to do is we are going to give a training data, fine, we are going to start the training data, and then we are going to do the prediction index. So first let's do the training data. So the first thing what we are going to do is training underscore df is equal to df dot filter, open the tuple and the big brackets, and we're gonna put it as close, fine, yeah, this is done, and then we're gonna put it as date data underscore unscaled, fine, unscaled is equal to train underscore df dot values, fine, we're going to give it as values, fine, this should be fine, yeah. And once we have given this, now we are going to get the numbers of rows of to train, fine, we're going to get the numbers of rows we want to train. So train df train data, oh yeah, train data underscore length, oh yeah, underscore length is equal to math dot ce, yep, and we'll put the len and tuple, and then data underscore unscaled, and then we're going to put the multiplication is multiplied to 0.8, fine, and we're going to click enter. Now once these things are done, we are moving forward to transforming features by scaling each other. So we want to transform each features to each feature. So we'll do something called as m scaler, or we'll do it as m scaler is equal to min max scaler, we have already imported this, so if you're asking where did it come from, you can get it in the top. So we'll put the features dot range, and I want the range between 0 to 1, so we'll put 0 comma, did I put O, yeah, sorry for that, 0 comma 1, okay. And once this is done, what we are going to do next is we are going to bring numpy. So np data is equal to mm scaler dot fit transform data underscore unscaled, fine, Now once this is done, we are going to be sequence length, okay? Sequence length is equal to 50. Fine. So we are given the sequence length. I will give it in the problem. Not given. And M scalar also. I'm just checking. It should not be an error, right? So I'm just checking if everything is fine. M scalar. Yeah, should be good. Should be fine. I believe. Wait, did I do a mistake right here? No, should be good. Yep, should be fine, I believe. So now let's click enter and now we'll do the prediction index, fine. Now once we have done this, we are going to put index underscore close is equal to train df dot column, we can put, yeah, so columns and get underscore lock, fine. And in this we are going to put it as close, so we are going to bring the closing price right here, close. So wherever we use close, right, just get to know that's the closing price we are using. Fine. So even in order to do the training data also, we are going to use the closing price of 2019 2020 2021, all this stuff, fine. So you get it, good. Now what we're going to do is we're going to print it one for sure. So we'll put it as print index close, fine. And then later on what we're going to do is we're going to put the training df, or let's training underscore data and underscore length, fine, is equal to, we're gonna bring the math now, fine, the math package we used dot CEIL, fine. Now once this is done, we are going to put the numpy again, np data, numpy data, and we are going to put it as shape. We are going to do the shape also, shape, we are bring it to big bracket 0 and we will multiply it with 0.8. I hope you get it. Once we have done this, we are now moving ahead to create the training and test data now, fine. So we're going to create the training and test data, let's put as that, test data, fine. So now we'll do the training data, so let's put as training underscore data, okay, is equal to np underscore data, fine. And then we bring the big brackets and put it as 0 two dots and train data length, yeah, and then comma and two dots, fine. Now once this is done, we are going to do the test underscore data, okay, and we are going to assign it to numpy data big brackets, by data with breakfast training data, and I think I had to put len together, I had to put, forgot about that, sorry. And we're gonna minus it with the sequence, okay, So we're gonna minus it with the sequence length, and then we're gonna put it as dots and comma dot. Fine, and we're gonna click enter. Now, as I told you, after this is done, we are going to do the RNN data, and then after that, we are going to generate the test prediction or whatever you can call it as. So first let's do the RNN, let's figure that out. So first let's classify it, let's put it in, let's define it first, okay? So def, def parameterization is underscore data set. Fine, and we're gonna put the brackets and sequence. You're going to bring the sequence underscore length. Fine, length underscore train underscore df. Fine. And once we have done this, we have click enter. So sequence, I think I've missed out a letter right here. Yep, sequence underscore sequence underscore length, and after that we put the training data right here. Fine. Now what we're going to do is we are going to define this, obviously that's there. But before that, let's put, you know, x and y value again. X comma y is equal to big brackets and comma big brackets. So you assign x and y again to big brackets. Now once we have done this, we are going to do the data underscore len and is equal to train train df. Let's put it as train df, and then we want to put the shape. Wait, did I put the right one? I think we have put, yeah, train df shape is equal, and we're gonna put as 0. Fine. And once this is done, what we are going to do now is we are going to put the for I in range. We're going to bring the for loop for I in range, for I in range sequence, sequence length we can also bring, yeah, sequence length, and we'll bring the data length, yeah, both are there. Fine. Now once this is done, what we are going to do is we're gonna click enter. Fine. Now this is done, sequence length is done, date. Okay, I forgot one thing to mention right here. This thing, the two dots should come, or it won't be shown, right? So the two dots are right here, and click enter. Fine. Now this is done, and we are going to put x dot append, append, and we're gonna bring the train train underscore, bring it top right here, yeah, train underscore df, train underscore df. And once we have done the train underscore df, we're gonna bring the big brackets and I minus sequence. Fine. Sequence length also could be brought, length, okay, sequence length. Fine. Once this is done, what we are going to do next is we are going to bring again the two dots I comma comma I, no, the two dots, yeah. Once the brackets are put, we'll click enter, and now we are going to bring the sequence length. So I'll bring it to the defined classing thing, sequence length into columns. Fine. Columns, have I put that columns? I'm not sure, let's try it. Yeah, wait, now let me just check this paint dot column sequence, and I think this should be fine. I'm not sure if I've made any mistake right here. Just check that length, and we put the length columns. I think it should be fine. I think later we can again redefine it. That should be good, I believe, right now. So let's move ahead. Let's click enter, and we will bring it to y dot append, and we are going to bring the train right here. So we'll put the train df or the big brackets and click enter. Fine. And after this is done, what we're going to do after the train df is, again we're going to bring i_index close. Fine. And we are going to bring this back right here. Let's bring this back to close. Should be fine. Yeah. And for this, let's bring it down. Y append close df should be fine. I think I'll just make this fine. I'll bring this right here, if I'm not wrong. Yep, should be fine. Df close. Yeah. And then we will click enter, and we're gonna put as columns. We're gonna put columns. Is equal to close, and I think we'll put the big. Oh, I didn't put the, yeah, now it should be fine. Close, and then the tuple. Fine. And then what we are going to do is we are going to put for single hyphen step prediction. Fine. For single step step prediction. Yep, should be fine. And now don't worry about the error thingy, it will just get rectified as we do our stuff. Just keep on doing the stuff and it gets fine after we have done. Now let's do one thing. Let's, you know, see, to be honest, this thing should not be even required because we are just going to assign it, right? So let me do one thing. Let me remove this right now because it's not required that much. So let's just focus on making the x and y value. I think x and y value will make it even more finally. So what we'll do is we'll bring it to 4 and we'll put it as x is equal to append. We're gonna take x is equal to append np dot raise array and x. Fine. And then again click enter, and y is equal to np dot array, and that will be the y. Yep, there you go. Now once this is done, what we are going to do is we are going to generate the training data and the test data. So once this is done, let's move ahead with the last and not least thing. We are going to basically get the fresh data. So once that is done, right, then almost everything is done. So what we'll do is right now is first let's finish with generating the data. So we'll put it as x or train. So we want to train it, right? So x train comma y_train is equal to distortion data set, and we're gonna click enter. And then the same thing, we can even do it for the Y also. So, but let's do one thing. Let's now for Y, let's put it for test also. So we'll put it for the test underscore, sorry, comma underscore test. Fine. And once this is done, we are going to put is equal to, and we are going to bring the version data set. Yeah. Now these things are done, and we'll click enter. And now let's move ahead with the printing of the plus stock percentage and stuff. So this is going to be the last but not the least. So we are going to put as plus is equal to, we'll bring it in string. So we are going to add it as plus, we'll bring it as means, and is equal to none. Fine. And we'll click enter. And now once we have done this, we are going to print the closing price from the Yahoo Finance we have taken. So we'll put it as print the closing price yeah, that should be fine. And we will put it in flower brackets, and we will put the predicted price from Yahoo Finance. Okay, so once we have done this, we are just going to either you can even put the stock name once if you want, but I'm not put it. Now here I might add a few more things. Now let me do one thing. If I continue doing this, the video might elaborate. So let me do one thing. I'm anyways giving you the source code. So I'll add a few more stuff in between right here and give you the source code, so it'll be easier for you. So if I have to simply explain you, it's nothing. It's just going to take from Yahoo Finance. From Pandas, it's going to take the data. We have done the training data and the test data, and it's going to take the extraction from the closing price of all the years, and from the Yahoo Finance of the shareholding, promoter holding, all these things. It's going to take the data and give it back to you. Now, I'll do one thing. I will add all those stuff, not the training, those things are already there. I'll add one is the visual data that is required, and the zoom in closer time frame. So that I have not done, so let me add that, because if I do that, the video might elaborate a bit more, and I'm sure most of the people would not like that. So I'll do one thing, I will anyways give you the source code. So if you before accessing the source code, you need to check out the video on how to access the source code. So I'll leave these two, you guys can get that, check out, and then put that, and it'll make your job easier. So let me quickly change the source code and get back to you, and let's do and run the program. Okay, so here I am with the whole source code and stuff, the whole program, not the source code, correction, where I added the visual data and also the required stuff which was required for that. Because if I have kept on explaining these things, zoom in, time frame and all, it would take a long time and most people would not like it. So that's why we are going to do this. And now we are going to predict, let's run this program and then let's see what is the whole thing. So we are going to run right now, and once we have done this, it's going to take the help of TensorFlow. With the help of TensorFlow, it's going to give me a data. So once this data is given, it's going to tell me, ask the stock name. So right now I'll take one stock name, that is let's take Tata Motors. And once I've given the Tata Motors, I'll click enter Motors, And yeah, as you can see, now it's started the whole, let me do one thing. Now it's given me the graph. Now it has given me the, it has completed, and here is the graph of the company. Now in the beginning I told you it's not 100% accurate. Oh, this is the graph, and here if you see, it's giving me 2019, as I told you in the beginning, 2020, 2021, 2022 also. Now if you are wondering, it's just an image. Now if you see, there's an X and Y coordinate right here. So if I bring it here, it's changing from 2021 to 2020 and then 2019 also. So I will close this, and now it will start extracting the closing price, the profit and loss, shareholding. Now you will get to know. It'll just start in a moment. Yep, there you go. So we have done this. This now it's taking the training data, it's taking all those required information. Once it's done, it will see it's taking the losses also. And once this is done, it will provide me a chart right here. Yes, here's the chart. So this is the prediction chart versus the growth rate. So if you see, we are assigned training data. So this is the training data, and we have also done a test prediction. So that test prediction will be shown here, and the growth rate is actually it's going up. So according to that, Tata Motors is actually going up, and it's not just Indian stock. You can even go for a foreign stock also, like Starbucks and stuff. So you can check out that also. And if you see, it is showing me the XY coordinates. If you see, it's right here, 2021. This is showing December. If I bring it low, it will show even November also. So according to the prediction, it meant it had to go top, but again it came down. So this is the prediction date, the graph we have done. So stock market prediction bot. Now if I close this, it will even give me the closing price. It might close, it's given the prediction that closing price might be low today. So that's what it's given. So this is basically how a stock market prediction bot works. Now it's not the 100% accurate prediction, I'll tell you, but we can create a stock market prediction. Now later in this channel, on this series, we are going to bring a video on how to connect this stock market prediction to our virtual assistant, where our virtual assistant will ask us which stock we want to predict, and it will do the prediction. Okay, so I hope you understood the whole thing what we did today. Even though in the ending I'll apologize for that, because obviously the video length might be even more and not everyone will like it, so I just had to import few stuff. But apart from that, I just added, I'll leave you the source code. So I hope you guys enjoyed and understood today's video. So till then guys, have a great day, happy coding, and peace out. We'll be right back.